Is that her?
Hello, boring.
Why are you wearing that?
I'm just playing the part.
I give you my blessing.
I have to tweet to all my friends.
Oh gosh, I forgot. You're 15.
Ow! Walking into the screening of a romantic comedy, Just Go With It, left me with very little of any surprising expectations. Movies that have starred Adam Sandler, with only a few exceptions, can only lead to knowing what's going to come first. Rude and crude humor and occasionally mean-spirited moments. What Adam's provided to us lately was more of that same formula, and this comes from someone who laughed hard at Happy Gilmore, Big Daddy, and Click. But there's no arguing that his humor has been going down the drain by repeating the same attempts over the past decade, and I'll definitely give you that I found The Waterboy, Little Nicky, and You Don't Mess With Zohan to be absolute garbage. Adam, take my advice and never try to voice a different accent. I hate to hear you sound like a retard. Now, somewhere along the way, I can somewhat see him mature a little more, even if, problematically speaking, it's at a very slow rate. Just Go With It has a small chunk of his maturity, but still contains the rude and crude humor. Another thing to go over is that I am never big on chick flicks at all. Most of the time, it's the exact same routine repeated over and over again as I provide the following. Guy meets girl, girl meets guy, they get together, they break up, they form back together, and then get married. This routine is so generic that it's been used on other movies than just chick flicks. Unfortunately, it was either this movie to watch for Valentine's Day, Romeo and Juliet, which looked like garbage by the premise alone, or The Eagle, which my girlfriend would have never wanted to watch. Wasn't much of a choice, so Just Go With It was the closest choice to think of. Damn, I never thought I'd write two paragraphs for an intro to a small movie. Anyway, Just Go With It stars Adam Sandler as Daniel, who is a plastic surgeon. He uses his old engagement ring from a wedding he was once in before he was rejected by his ugly appearances, and pretended to be married as he lied to any woman saying his wife was careless. He eventually meets someone he falls in love with named Palmer, and hangs out with her on a regular basis. Unfortunately, after Palmer finds his old engagement ring and believing he is married, Daniel uses his old dirty trick again, but uses his assistant, played by Jennifer Aniston, to play through the lying play. From this point forward, there are lies after lies and various mishaps that people in this movie easily buy into for all the cliches you can think of. One of the biggest things to give credit to is that the children who are in the film have acted pretty well for the most part. In fact, there's a girl whose character involves acting lessons. In addition, there are some pretty funny moments with them by their own deals and attempts to blackmail Daniel. Without them, there are still laughs, but only to a minimum. On the mature side though, there's much less potty jokes and occasionally stupid moments. The film's content aims more to the matter of getting with the girl, engagement, and others in which is what adults face. That unfortunately doesn't hide the stupidity either. What Daniel does is all the wrong reasons, and not once does she acknowledge that, no matter how formulated his situation is. Not the slightest bit does the movie try to hide the incompetence. While acting British, Palmer's lied to that the girl was raised in England. Without a moment of suspicion, she just buys into it. In fact, Palmer's lied to several times and she just goes with it for what she's told. There's not a single moment where she demands the truth. Well, according to O'Hare, I guess that's supposed to be a blonde joke. Another guy jumps in the play out of nowhere, and they have to go with that. But the idea was from Jennifer Aniston, who advised this after telling Daniel she'll lose her if he tells her the truth. I can see why it's just titled Just Go With It. Despite the movie's background, it's because a lot of these plot points are so effortless that the movie doesn't want to explain. They just want you to go with what they got. I wanted to sit and enjoy most of the laughs, which may I add, there were a lot of. But thinking about this movie over time, it just doesn't age well at all. It's not completely terrible, there are some good moments here and there. But still, even for my enjoyments of Adam Sandler's filmography, it's far from my recommendation. This is not one of his best, but again, to some credibility, there's a little more maturity. Adam, take my advice since it's wearing out quickly, and stop using the rude and crude humorous formula. You're good in more dramatic films now. I'd like to see more of that.
Just go with it.
To the overall rating, 2 stars out of 5.